Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Could you please stand and prudently greet those around you? Our gathering hymn this afternoon is Gather Us In.
Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this face our fears and our dreamings brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in the lost and forsaken. Gather us in the blind and the lame. Call to us now and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather us in the rich and the haughty. Gather us in the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly. Give us the courage to enter the song.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We gather together as a parish family on this beautiful fall day to give praise and thanks to our God for the many ways that God shows his love for us, to gather around our family table, to be nourished on the very presence of Jesus Christ, so that we may be able to go forth from this place to be Christ's presence, to be Christ's body, to be Christ's church for one another and for our world. As we gather together, we welcome all our visitors. We are delighted to have you with us. We hope that you feel very welcome, very much at home here at St. Mary's, and that you're able to join us often. We welcome in a special way our guests of other faith traditions. You honor us with your presence. Remind you that under this roof, we are all one family, children of the same God, sisters and brothers to one another. And so now, as God's children, let us pause for a moment to call to mind our sinfulness and let us ask God for forgiveness. Lord Jesus, your love for us is far greater than we could ever imagine or ever hope for. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you call us to love one another. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body, with your blood, to nourish us on our journey. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, look upon us, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Sirach.
Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustices. Then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anybody nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon of his own sins? If one of you is but flesh, cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbors. Remember the Most High covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he put our transgressions from us. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. If we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is the way Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the living and the dead. The word of the Lord.
Thanks Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I give you a new commandment, says the Lord, love one another as I have loved you.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
The reading today is taken from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. This is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no other way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave the loan. When the servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when the fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, you wicked servant, I forgave your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord. Charged with rape and the murder of a young woman, it took the jury minutes to return a guilty verdict for the three men on trial. The courtroom erupted in cheers as the verdict was read out. As the men were being led away from the courtroom, the mother of two of them ran toward them yelling, I think what you did is despicable, but I want you to know that I love you. Outside the courthouse, the media was expecting the parents of the victim to advocate capital punishment for the criminals. Instead, they wanted to forgive the perpetrators of the vicious crime. Everyone looked on in disbelief. No one at the courtroom was running away from the heinous nature of the crimes, nor from the life sentence that the men deserved. But the parents involved chose to focus on love and forgiveness. This weekend, we mark the 19th anniversary of that infamous day, September 11th, 2001. 9 years ago, a beautiful monument at Ground Zero was dedicated to the thousands of individuals who lost their lives that day, including those heroes who gave their lives trying to save the lives of others. Throughout the country and all over the world, memorials in stone and steel have been erected to honor the lost and those who rushed to the rescue. We need memorials like that, but we also need memorials in our hearts and in our minds, living memorials. Today's readings call us to inscribe one word on those memorials: forgive. Forgive. But how does one forgive the hatred, the lives taken, the families broken? It's not easy. Not easy at all. But if we're to move forward, we need to let go of the hatred. For forgiveness looks to the future. Forgive means detesting and condemning horrendous acts without hating those who commit them. Forgive means working towards peace and understanding wherever we can make a difference. Forgive means refusing to make judgment about people because of their dress, their religion, or nationality. Forgive means being aware of individuals and collective of sins and failings and our own need for forgiveness. There are tainted spots in our lives, just as there have been in the history of our church and our country. 9/11 memorials made of stone remind us of the despicable acts of the past and of those who died because of it. But we must not let those memories steep us in hatred. Hatred only leads to more hatred. Hatred leads to violence, and violence begets violence. Memorials in our hearts, built upon the difficult efforts to forgive, help us to create a future where the hope for peace can shine more brightly for generations to come. What better monument can we create for those loved ones lost and those who out of love gave their lives than to strive for a better future, to work for the kingdom of God, a kingdom of peace, justice, and love. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, for death on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we are invited to the banquet table of our heavenly Lord, let us now offer our prayers and concerns for ourselves and for the entire world.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For our call of to stewardship, that we may be good stewards of the gifts that God has given us, by addressing the challenges of our parish community, and by responding generously with time, talent, and treasure, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deep awareness of God's boundless forgiveness, that in our daily living, our experiences, and of our weaknesses, we may recognize how God's unlimited forgiveness each day, and that experience of forgiveness gives us the strength to forgive others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been impacted by hurricanes or wildfires, and for the firefighters and relief workers, that God will give them strength, protect them from harm, and speed the assistance that they need, and that God will renew their strength, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the end to the pandemic, that God will guide and inspire all who work to end this virus, and give all our leaders the wisdom to make right decisions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are in need of healing or peace in their lives, especially members of our parish family, that God's gracious spirit will give their bodies and minds comfort and wholeness. We especially pray for Maggie Wilkins, Philip Lind, Barbara Chabineau, Andrea Lloyd, Dottie Kelly, Scott, Nicole, Eddie Fitzgerald, Gail, Kay Lee, Nancy, Kimberly, Ashley, Zachary Kay, Deanne Hall, Jane, and all those who have been impacted by abuse in any form, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they be brought into eternal peace of God's presence through Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life. For all who have died this week, and especially for Carlo Capuano, Patricia Finnegan, Richard and Isabel Pope, Marco Pencherira, whom we remember at this Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, and those prayers in people who are written in our book of intentions and never be forgotten by God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, we come before you with our cares and our concerns, those that we have spoken and all those that lie deep within our hearts. We ask you to hear our prayer and to grant it according to your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Our hymn during the presentation of gifts is I Am the Bread of Life.
Upon the last day.
of the flesh of the Son of Man, and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our ever-loving Father. O Lord, look with favor on our supplications, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice together we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the
God, you are indeed holy, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before Jesus was given up to death, the death he freely accepted, he took bread. In giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and he said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took a cup that was filled with wine. Once more, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave it to his friends. And he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be shed for you and for all, so that sin may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, with all the bishops and all your people. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And now, as one family, united with our sisters and brothers all over the world and with our sisters and brothers who've gone before us, let us pray now for the coming of God's kingdom.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us as we forgive others, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant a peace in unicorns with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
My sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now, in a prudent way, let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Agnus Dei,
qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, we call it.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who call to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy.
Should enter my room.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot do that at this moment, receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, may the working of this heavenly gift, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Next weekend, in addition to our 4:30 Mass on Saturday evening inside and our 10 a.m. Mass outside, weather permitting, we will also have a 5 o'clock Sunday Mass also outside, weather permitting. My friends, the Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our final hymn of praise this afternoon is Sing to the Mountains.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice.
I will give thanks to you, my Lord. You have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death. You are my strength and my song. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Of your glory. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Let